Hey guys, Shredly here, and today was the announcement of the new World of Warcraft expansion pack, World of Warcraft Legion. Now, I'm standing on top of Karazhan, the Medivh's tower, where Khadgar was in the announcement trailer, and basically I'm going to be with my friend Mal here, or that's Maleficent, Mal for short, and we're going to be going over just a few of the new things that they announced. Go ahead and say hello.
Hi.
Alrighty. Yeah, basically we're just going to be flying around and talking about this kind of stuff. So what is first on the bullet points here?
Well, I think the most exciting first bullet point is the new class. I am delighted by this.
Oh my god, I know.
The Demon Hunters, oh my gosh. Illidan is one of my favorites. I actually started out on the Illidan realm and then moved to Stormrage at some point, and I found it hilarious that I went from first name to last name. But
yeah, that is kind of weird. But when I first, I was at work when the announcement all went out, and when you told me that it was Demon Hunters, my brain first went to the Diablo Demon Hunter, where they have the crossbows and stuff like that. But then you're like, no, Illidan. I'm like, oh.
Yep.
Like, my pupils dilated, and I got, like, really excited. I got, like, nervous sweats.
Ow. Ew. Smelly.
It was weird.
But we get a lot of really cool options with these Demon Hunters. We get to pick our horns, our tattoos, our skin colors. Heck, they're even giving us the chance to, you know, do different kinds of eye covers.
I'm over here. I'm in Blasted Lands.
I think now. I ran into a rock.
Good job. I'm coming back.
I'm fine,
but yeah,
too.
I saw the they're both factions are gonna get Demon Hunters, but the only race is elves.
Yep.
So Blood Elves are not elves. The Blood Elf eye covers, oh my god, those look so cool. I mean, they're very regal and red and gold looking.
Mm-hmm.
And the Night Elf ones are very Illidan, you know, you can get it off the Illidan boss in the Black Temple. Kinda like that. Also, I love the fact that you can choose, I read this, that you can choose to have horns or no horns.
Why would you choose no horns, though? Horns are such a cool part of being the Demon Hunter.
Yeah, that is very true.
Being an Illidari.
Mm-hmm, yeah. I wonder if you can do, like, little horns.
Oh, one of the screenshots I did see had tiny horns. They were like little, like, nubbin goat horns.
Yeah, that'd be neat.
Yeah, I'm gonna go for big swoopy looking ones.
Mm-hmm. What do you think of the fact that they only have two specs, DPS or tank?
I like it.
I do too.
I would argue a second DPS spec for doing a ranged, perhaps. But
nah.
the two specs and leaving the healer out of it, I like it.
Yeah, well, they didn't want to add a third spec. The healing didn't make much sense, and if they added another DPS spec to it, they felt like it would really just muddle the whole thing.
Oh, yeah.
Which I totally agree with.
I can see it, yep.
Yeah. But what were the two specs? Havoc.
Havoc and Vengeance.
Havoc was the DPS one, and Vengeance was the tanking one.
Mm-hmm.
The Havoc one had the big wings, and it was very spiky, and it looked very... It looked awesome.
That spiky, awesome giantness is from the metamorphosis that you get to eventually learn how to do.
Yeah.
So.
And the Vengeance spec looked a lot like a tank. It literally was like...
Bulky.
Like you had bulky and like very, very thick scales or like armor, it looked like. Very neat.
While the Havoc spec, which I'm going to go down, is so lethal looking. It looks so Viper and so just clean, fast, and agile.
Yeah. What else was it? They also, this kind of made me chuckle a little bit. They have the ability to double jump.
Oh, I'm going to climb all over crap I've never been able to.
Oh, my God. I know, right? I'm going to be just double jumping. That's it.
And be like, oh, you want on that building? You can't. I can. Ha, ha, ha.
Yeah. Now, the fact that it's a hero class, they did mention that it is going to be... They're going to start out at a higher level.
Mm-hmm.
What level do you think that they are going to... Oh, hello, Horde player. What level do you think they are going to start out at?
So, they were talking about they wanted to start at a higher level, so we didn't have to go through any of the old content.
Yes.
I was playing around with some math earlier on this, going, well, when the first hero class, the Death Knight, was introduced, you were 30 levels lower than the cap. So you started at 50 when the cap was 80. If they went with that same model, you'd have been 80 with the cap of 110. That meant I'd have to go through Pandara, and I'm not that big of a fan of that one. But it was fun while it lasted, but yeah. I don't need to go back.
Hmm.
I'm thinking they might set us at 90.
I think 90 would be a good... 90 might make sense because of the fact, you know, going through Draenor with, you know, the Burning Legion is very strong there. There's a lot of demons.
Yep.
And,
It makes sense thematically.
Yeah. And they did mention that you are going to, air quotes here, see through Illidan's eyes.
Yep. That's part of the starting experience with being a demon hunter is we're going to see what he had to do to become what he did, and we're going to learn the, quote, true meaning of sacrifice.
Hmm. That's interesting. And they did show a few pictures of the what looks like their starting zone. You're going to be on a different planet. I'm not exactly sure what the name of it is.
Dimension.
Dimension, something like that.
We're going through a portal door somewhere.
Exactly. But I'm... Are you?
Yeah, finally.
Yeah. but yeah, I'm really excited for the Demon Hunter class. That's going to be a lot of fun. Really cool that they're introducing a new hero class. I mean, finally.
Yeah, since Lich King.
Yeah, when they... Their first hero class. Their one and only so far.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think that's going to be a huge, huge thing. I know a lot of people are probably going to roll Demon Hunter right away. And from the screenshot, it looks like their weapons are going to be glaives. They might have dual wielding. That's what I'm thinking. Dual wielding.
Yes. What is it? They talked about that briefly. It's actually listed at the website what you're going to be able to use or not use.
Okay.
And so.
Yeah, I didn't really look that up.
I did while I was at work, so it didn't stick in my memory.
But speaking of weapons, they
artifacts.
Artifact weapons. Each class is going to have their own artifact weapon. Two of the really big ones that they mentioned were Ashbringer and Doomhammer.
Yep. They're iconic. That's why they're talking about them. Everybody knows Ashbringer when you see it. Everybody knows Doomhammer. I mean, come on now.
Yeah, and they did mention the fact that you are going to be able to customize these weapons.
Mm-hmm. Which, I saw the pictures. They're drool-worthy.
Yeah, they had like... Ashbringer, they had like corrupted Ashbringer, one with like lightning going all through it.
That one, that's the shattered one. It is by far my favorite looking one, right next to the flaming one.
I like classic Ashbringer. It just brings it back to memories with like the corrupted Ashbringer and all that stuff. But yeah, I saw the mage ones and. Obviously I got a little like ooh mage stuff and holy crap, some of them look really cool. There's one that's like all engulfed in fire and kind of reminds me of the legendary mage staff.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
The Death Knight one, Frostmourne. I about peed my pants when I saw that bad boy. She is going to be beautiful when we get done with her. They didn't do too much artistic styling on their different sets for Frostmourne, just because if you're playing a Death Knight, you want skulls.
Yeah, you definitely want skulls.
Skulls and frosty things, and I'm I was petting my screen when they showed the pictures because it's just like I want that.
They also had Soul Reaver too.
Well, that's because you're going to turn Frostmourne into two separate rune blades.
Oh.
Because dual wielding frost Death Knights are king, and I love them. You can never make me play with a one hander. or
a two-hander.
A two-hander, one sword. Such a confusing wording.
Yeah.
But whatevers.
But it looks like all of the different weapons will have like different specs too to kind of make them your own.
They are. Your weapon levels and customizes with you. So it's going to be very, very special.
All right, sorry about the little cut there. What were we talking about?
We were talking about... Were we still talking about hero classes? No, we were talking about artifacts.
Artifact weapons, that's right, yes. We were talking about how, you know, they got the Ashbringer, Doomhammer...
Frostmourne.
And how... Oh, yeah, they have their own little skill trees.
Yes. And you're going to be able to level those weapons up by doing dungeons. They're going to keep dungeons relevant for us. We won't stop after a few weeks.
Yeah. Because with Draenor, I mean, they didn't have a whole lot of dungeons. I mean, I saw a thing where Wrath of the Lich King had more raids than Draenor had dungeons.
Yeah.
So... I mean, if they have dungeons, I mean, that's... And if they have rewards for running those dungeons, like, stuff that, you know, makes you want to do these dungeons, like upgrading your artifact weapon and, you know, obviously getting loot and
grinding.
Yes, rep grinding. If they brought back that'd be great. I would love that because...
So would
I mean, you got so many cool mounts from rep grinding in Wrath of the Lich King. Well,
and Burning Crusade.
Mm-hmm. And, I mean, it was like a reward. Like,
it was a nice reward.
Mm-hmm. Because, I mean, you got a mount. It's like, yeah, I worked hard for this mount. And,
I'm riding right now.
Oh, yeah, exactly. That one's actually from Burning Crusade.
Mm-hmm. I love my pretty hippogriff. I worked so hard to get him.
Yeah, I got that one, too. It's pretty nice. But, yeah, having stuff like that in the game, that would really help, you know, kind of make the environment feel a little more...
usable.
Yeah, and immersive.
Yep. And speaking of dungeons, since we're there, I believe they have 9 of them planned.
Ooh.
At least
I know,
from the
I
screenshots,
know,
it looks like there's 9.
Yeah, I saw a few. I know they have... God, I don't have the list in front of me. I know they said Violet Hold was going to be on there, like the secrets of Violet Hold, and you're going to learn a little bit more about the history of the world. Not
of Dalaran.
Just, yeah, and of Dalaran, too, and the mages there, and Khadgar.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. There's Violet Hold, Black Rook Hold, the Eye of Ashara. My brain just glitched. I'm really excited about Eye of Ashara. It's more Night Elf lore. It's just...
Ooh. Yeah, that'd be great.
So much lore.
There was one that started with an S, and it was like the center. It was in the center of the world map. And, God, can't remember it. And
ooh,
I don't have it in front of me.
Saramar Palace.
That's it. That one really caught my eye, because it's like the City of Night...
It's like the capital of Night Elves and basically a graveyard.
Yeah. Well, that's what they were saying was the whole kind of Broken Isles continent is going to be like one huge graveyard almost.
Yep. It's like forgotten memories and just a Night Elf hub, the center of where Night Elves came from, essentially.
Yeah, pretty much.
And it's got roots in Warcraft 3, so this isn't made up, folks.
Yeah. But, yeah, all the dungeons that they're planning for this look gorgeous, too.
Mm-hmm. Oh, the the screenshots and the artwork that they're giving us teasers. I'm just like, this is so pretty. All the new zones. Oh, there's some zones I'm really looking forward to.
Name off the zones. I don't have them in front of me.
The zones. Oh, come back here, zones. I just had them all. Okay, we've got... the one I'm looking forward to the most is Stormheim.
It's, oh, yeah.
The Tarn and stuff are up there.
Yeah.
With the
yeah,
really cool horns.
They're Moose Tauren.
Elk.
I saw the horns.
Elk
Those
Tauren.
Are moose.
They
are
elk.
Meese. Meese. I don't care. I saw the horns. I thought, oh my god, that's a Moose Tauren. When are we going to be able to play as Moose Tauren?
I bet you the Horde are all over wanting to play as Moose Tauren.
Oh my god, if my main right now were a Tauren mage right now, I'd be all like, I want to be a Moose Mage.
Oh, you'd have to have a name that started with that M.
It would be Maurice.
Maurice the Moose.
Moose Mage. Maurice the Moose Mage.
I like that.
Ooh, is it raining over here?
I don't know. I've lost you again. Every time we go through a new zone, you like phase out on me and I stop following you.
Doesn't matter, it's raining.
Okay.
Oh, it's raining here and it's raining in real life.
Okay.
Ooh, I was like lightning, but no, that's just Brill.
Okay. So, another one of the zones is Valshara. I think I'm saying that right. Valshara.
I'm going to say Valshara.
So am I. It just sounds right. I can't remember what this zone was about. I feel like this one was...
Nagas, I would say?
No.
I would say...
No. This is all above ground stuff. This is... I want to say this is... Druidic.
Oh, yeah, that's right. This is,
Malfurion
became the first... Yeah, that's where he became the first druid.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. That's right. I remember that now. But there is going to be a Naga zone, if I recall correctly.
I don't remember hearing or seeing that.
I know there's something about Naga. I saw it. I think. Where is this thing?
Okay.
Ooh, I think it's over here.
Did you?
No, I'm just trying to find something for my fairy dragon.
Oh.
Okay. Let's see here. They have those the hero halls. Halls.
The class order halls.
Class order hero halls. That's right. Yep. Ooh, I found it. Yes. Little fairy ring. There's a little fairy. Oh.
Are you at the special dragon? Are they doing their thing?
Uh-huh, it's happening.
Oh my god, I'm on my way. I want that. You can get that scroll for their music.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, cool.
I forget what you have to do, though. But I want to come...
Something?
I forget.
Well, hurry up. They're gathering. They're not running away.
My hippogriff is flying as fast as its little wings can.
Okay, well, I'm gonna perch on top of this mushroom.
Okay.
And we'll keep talking about class orders.
The class orders. These look really cool. They want to focus on, so Alliance and Horde, we're at each other's throats because that's just what we do. But they want to focus on class identities and what is it to be a Death Knight? What is it to be a mage? What is it to be a paladin? And we are going to, they're kind of like garrisons, but an evolved, better version.
I remember they're saying something about you're not creating an army.
No,
it's more of like a air quotes knights of the round table.
Yep.
A
select few who stand out and beyond that come to you, essentially, from what it sounds like. We're not finding them. They're coming to us. And they're going to help us explore out into the world. We will be able to send them on things, but they might find stuff for us to go do. To take us back out of our little, you know, special hole that we're hiding in.
Yeah.
And I like that. I like the idea that they're going to find... they're gonna find things for me to do, and it's gonna drive me to go out and do stuff out there. And only people who are of your class are gonna be able to be in these places. So you're only gonna see mages. I'm only gonna see Death Knights. Hunters will only see hunters. And they're
Think of the Death Knight starting zone.
Yes. Oh, I flew right past you. I was so excited talking about this stuff. Look at them, they're doing their stuff.
Ooh, they haven't started yet.
But there are people here waiting.
Yeah, so I think we're gonna see something soon. I'm just gonna keep recording right here.
That's fine. This is a pretty spot. This is one of these little hidden gem spots that you've gotta find it and know about it.
Well, actually, all right, we're gonna go a little off topic here. Back in vanilla, this was here, and the only way you could get to this spot was kind of walking over invisible walls and getting to it. But there's actually a little lake somewhere around here. I wonder if I can find it. But there's like a little story that's hidden around this area, and it's actually really neat. Maybe this is the lake over here. Yeah, this is the lake. There's like a sunken aircraft in here or something.
Really?
Yeah. There it is. Boop. There it is.
Cool.
Yeah, there's like a little hidden backstory, and this was all here in vanilla. And the only way you could get to it was jumping through invisible walls by wall walking, essentially. And here it is. This was all here back then. And when they added flying to the rest of Azeroth, obviously they couldn't keep this away from everybody else, so they kind of did a little, I want to say like a little homage to the whole thing by, getting a little vertigo from the swimming and trying to control my camera. I won't. It's like a little homage, and they made a little thing where fairy drakes or fairy darters will come and sing a song around this like weird mushroom thing. Mm-hmm. And I gotta get back on my mount.
They've all lined up here.
Oh, are they ready? Are they doing it?
I don't know if they're singing or not, but everybody's lined up. No, I don't have music notes. Oh, we've started.
Oh, they're doing it. They're doing it. Okay, a little little bonus in this little theory crafting thing.
Sweet! I got a scroll!
Oh, I want that. Did I get it?
Yes, you did.
Oh, cool. I totally got it.
Oh,
sweet.
This is one of the... You've got to be here at the right time.
Oh, yeah.
To get this particular scroll to play in your garrison. And I'm excited. I have it.
Let's see here. 10 p.m. local time. That's when I was here. 10 p.m. local time. Check it out.
Sweet.
You get a little bonus in this video. Get to see this really cool. And actually, look at you get to see all these other little diseased creatures like come up to it and kind of just watch. Even critters will come up to it. And when they're done singing their song, they drift back away.
They fly away.
Mm-hmm. Another little interesting tidbit about this was. People had theorized that this ring is the burial spot of Sargeras, or an old god. There's an old god buried here, and that's why these fairy drakes do this little ritual.
I wonder if it's a dragon.
Maybe green dragonflight with the Emerald Dream and stuff like that. But I'm not 100%.
Oh, that'd be really flipping cool with the new expansion.
Yes, because they mentioned there is, a dungeon or an instance with you go into the Emerald Nightmare.
That's a raid.
It's a raid. Yeah,
it's a raid.
Mm-hmm. And you go into the Emerald Nightmare and you get to see some of the Emerald Dream.
Yep. Which is wonderful, because there is so much really cool lore around the Emerald Dream and the Emerald Nightmare. The Emerald Nightmare is where Illidan ended up and went all off his rocker. Right. So. It's just, it's going to be very, very neat. Let's see. I can find some, oh, some bullet points for the Emerald Nightmare. It's going to have 7 bosses in it. And it's just going to be really cool. It's the Emerald Dream all twisted and knotted up and just gross and dirty and lucky.
Yeah.
So.
And apparently we go into a tree.
Well, yeah, because that's where the Emerald Dream is held.
Well, yeah, you walk into a tree.
Yeah. I mean, it's a druidic thing. What do you think? So.
Yeah. Oh, no, he's killing these things. Yeah.
Who is?
Ah, this guy.
You
I don't
jerk.
Know. I'm not clicking on him because I can't because I got my UI off. Anyways, so yeah, it's a good thing we came over here because, oh, this is pretty from up top.
Is it?
Yeah, can you say thumbnail? This is going to be the thumbnail of the video. All right, it's gone.
Aw, everybody went away.
Yeah, but anyways, it was a good thing we came here because, we got to see that, and B, it kind of segued into our little Emerald Dream
it did.
Talk that we're going to have.
That was really nice.
I love that Blizzard is going to bring in the Emerald Dream finally into World of Warcraft.
I know.
For the longest time, they've only really hinted at it. And
it's a thing. We all know it exists. Why are we ignoring it?
Yeah, we've never gotten to really go there or see it. I mean, it's always been like one of those mysterious things of World of Warcraft that, you know, players really want to go see this.
Mm-hmm.
And finally, we're going to be able to go to the Emerald Dream. And I'm super excited. I would love to go to the Emerald Dream. Just to see what it's like. I mean, are trees growing upside down?
I'm gonna think a lot of chaos and disorder. And a lot of green.
Yeah. Kinda, I would assume you would be... the way I'd phrase it is probably like that twilight stage between like your sleep cycles... where you're kind of awake, but everything's kind of still blurry.
Very surreal.
Yeah, and yeah, kind of. That's how I'd expect the Emerald Dream. And actually, we're coming up to a really cool part where Dalaran used to be.
That is true. We're going to see where it got ripped out.
Uh-huh. Dalaran was over here in a gigantic bubble, and it's actually a good thing. Well, Dalaran moved to Northrend.
Yep.
And now Dalaran is moving
again
to the Broken Isles, and it's going to be
it's our hub.
I mean, back in Wrath of the Lich King, Dalaran had two sides. It was like split in half, Horde and Alliance.
Oh, look at the pretty destruction.
Oh, yeah. If you go down here, you can actually see where the sewers are.
Oh, I know. I've tried to crawl in them. It doesn't quite work.
Yeah, no. Down here in the sewers. Oh, what's this? What's this little guy?
What'd you find?
I don't know. Dead player? What is this? Is that a dead player? Looks like
No. Crusader Jorny the Defied.
Hmm.
Who are you?
Did he fall off when... I wonder if he fell off when Dalaran was...
being ripped out of its skull? Maybe.
But yeah, we're going to go to Dalaran again for our hub. And I'm actually really excited for that because...
a hub.
We're not going to be cooped up in our garrisons.
I know. So when I started playing World of Warcraft, what I really liked was I was able to play with lots of different kinds of people from across the planet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I got that, you know, all through Lich King. It was wonderful. And then Kata still had it going on. It was awesome. Pandora.
You were back in Orgrimmar and...
Stormwind.
Stormwind.
Mm-hmm.
Pandaria,
we had
the two shrines.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And then here in Draenor... I have my garrison.
Yeah. Well, and actually in Burning Crusade, I know you didn't play during then, but Burning Crusade, we had Shattrath, and Shattrath was huge, and it was awesome.
Shattrath was divided kind of into quarters, too. There were places that certain people couldn't go because of the Alliance you had with factions.
Yes, the Aldor and the Scryer,
yes.
Which were really cool because if you were Alliance or Horde, it didn't matter which faction you picked, and you got to pick them. If you were Alliance, you could pick the Aldor because, I mean, they're Blood Elf, but a lot of the times the reason you picked which one you wanted to be in was because it had better stuff for your particular class.
Or how you wanted to play your character, yeah.
Exactly, yeah. And, I mean, Scryers are more magical, so I went magic, or mage, so I went Scryers.
Yeah, I always went Aldor.
Yeah. And, I'm really excited to see Dalaran again. I wonder if it's going to be the same old Dalaran that we all know and love, or is it going to be changed?
Now, do you remember Dalaran when it was over in the location we were just at?
Yes, I do.
Is it the same as the one we've got over in Wrath right now?
Absolutely not. The
Then my guess is it's going to be a completely different Dalaran again.
Well, here's the thing. The Dalaran back in Vanilla, before it moved to Northrend, was just... It was a shield. There was a big bubble shield around it.
Okay.
You could not see into it. You could not walk into it. There was no absolute way of getting into it. There was... It was just... You got to the bubble and it said, Dalaran.
Huh.
Yeah. It was just enclosed in this big bubble. Big purple bubble. And you couldn't see it. Or you couldn't get into it. You couldn't see into it. I know I've... I think I've seen a few videos of people like... glitching on top of it, but it was the same all around. You could not get into it. Yeah. And when they moved it to Northrend, that's when it got ripped out of the ground and it became that giant crater.
Yeah.
And then now it's in Northrend and you can actually go to it. I mean, it's the hub. And when it was in Northrend, it was awesome. Like, I know I was level, I was 72, and I booked it from, what is it? Not the fjord, but,
the other side?
Boring Tundra.
Yes.
The Boring Tundra. I booked it from the Boring Tundra all the way through Dragonblight into the Crystal Song Forest. Very carefully. Ice blocked a lot. Ice blocked and invisibility. Just because I wanted to get to Dalaran. And when I finally got there, it was like, you had to do this quest to get up into it.
Oh, I remember that.
Yeah, instead of having to fly into it and whatnot. So I finally got up in there. And the first thing I did, I bought a bear. The bear mount.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. First thing I did was go and bought the bear mount. And I started riding that around. Because nobody else, I mean, there were a few good handful of people that were like 75, something like that, 76, that had the mount, but I was level 72 in Boring Tundra riding around on my bear mount. And it was super awesome, too. I loved
Sweet.
It. So I would love to see what they do with Dalaran, because if it's the same old Dalaran that we know and love... That's gonna hit everybody with like a huge everybody from Wrath at least.
Oh, right in the heartstrings.
Oh yeah, it's gonna be like, oh my God, here's the beer garden, and here's
Violet Hold. I have
romantic
pictures there. Or
yeah,
it,
yeah, and all the magical stuff that goes on there, but if they change it up. I mean, what's it going to look like? Are the factions, Horde and Alliance, going to still be separated?
I think so, yes.
Yeah.
Well, one of the things with Dalaran being Dalaran this time, this coming time, is Khadgar is actually in charge.
Yeah,
it's
that's
not,
right.
It's not Lady Progmore anymore. It's Khadgar.
Yeah, Jaina.
She had a stompy fit and stomped away or something. I'm actually not sure what happened there. I can't remember.
I was going to say
she had a stumpy fit.
I haven't been following up on the lore very much either.
Well, her lore is just uneventful for me. I'd rather follow Khadgar's or somebody else's.
Yeah.
So.
Jaina just seems like one huge teenage romance.
A little bit. Yeah. But, you know, there's something in this game for everybody, and I'm certain there's somebody out there that just loves that storyline.
Most likely. She is a cool character. She was awesome in Warcraft 3. I will say that. Back to theory crafting with So we hit up the class orders, the artifact weapons, the new class.
Let's see. We've talked about the island. We've talked about class. We've talked about the weapons. We've talked about the halls. What we haven't talked about is the honor system for PvP stuff or being able to level to level 110.
Okay, the fact that level cap is now 110, I'm glad they're doing the 10 levels again.
Yes.
The whole 5 levels,
it felt so fast and dirty.
Yeah, exactly. Like, you just got there all of a sudden, you're just like, alright, well, I guess time to start doing endgame.
Yeah, no kidding.
The fact that it's 110, I'm totally okay with. If they did 105, I would have been like, why an odd number, Blizzard?
Uh-huh. Part of me is like, can we just have new content without the leveling system? I'm still going to do new fun things if you give me new fun things to do. I don't need to be any bigger than 100. But
if they didn't add the extra levels, it wouldn't give you the incentive to go out and do the extra things. I know you would probably do it. I would probably do it. But
I'm a completionist. So
yeah, a lot of players would just be like, "All right, cool. No new level cap. I guess start doing end game."
Yep, that's
so
true.
So yeah, but the honor system.
Oh, PvP. That they.
I like that a lot.
Apparently, these are fixes that have been wanted for a while now. Why am I suddenly way high?
Because I'm going down. Okay. I'm going down into Dunmore.
Okay. Ooh, I like this zone.
Yeah. I wish it was snowing. But anyways, the honor system. I'm all for it because it looks like what's going to happen is, as you do more PvP, you're going to get more abilities for your class to do specifically in PvP.
Yep. It looks like there's a cool ranking system also.
Yes,
from
exactly.
I'm basing that off of one screenshot I saw.
Me too. It looks kind of like the very first PvP ranking system they ever did was where you filled up a bar, and once you filled up that bar, you hit the next rank, and you know, you would grind to High Warlord or First Marshal.
Yep.
For the Horde
Alliance.
Did you get
a title for that stuff?
I did. I got Senior Sergeant.
Cool.
I did that back in vanilla.
I might get back into PvP if I get cool titles and mounts out of it. Because the coolest mount I have, I think by far, is my one PvP mount that I have. And I grind like an SOB to get that stupid thing. But I got it, and I'm so happy I have it. I do this. Mm-hmm. I would do the same to get a really cool title.
Yeah, I mean, if they put that back in, I mean, people are going to do PvP more to get those better spells and abilities.
Oh, yeah.
So that they can be better in PvP.
Yep.
So I really like this idea. I like what they're doing with the new PvP system, and it actually makes... I'm not a huge PvP-er. Back in vanilla, when I was in a huge guild, we would do pre-mades and stuff like that all the time. So it was like, it didn't really matter. We all had tier gear, and it was just a blast. We were all in Ventrilo and doing all that stuff. And I thought it was super fun. But as, you know, the expansions went on, I kind of lost interest in doing PvP.
It got
boring and repetitive. And the fact that they're doing this with the honor system and stuff like that, I really, really like it. It's going to be a lot of fun, and it makes me, someone who doesn't PvP very often, want to do it.
Yep.
And I think they mentioned something about the gear, too.
I don't remember anything about the gear. I actually kind of zoned out at that point.
Yeah.
I was too busy drooling over what my artifact could eventually be. Because I'm also thinking about the hunter I have. And dear God in heaven, what bow are they going to give me?
Yeah, I know. Will it be like Sylvanas' bow?
That would be cool. Oh, don't tease me like that.
who knows what they're going to do with the artifact weapons. I mean, I know I saw like a little handful of them.
What is it? There are 36 of them?
One for every spec. Yeah. So every spec is going to have their own artifact weapon, which... It makes me wonder, like, pure DPS classes, like hunters and rogues and mages, mm-hmm. like, is, like, an arcane staff going to be all purple and glowy with, like, cool orbs floating around it, and a fire mage is going to have a nice, awesome, just flaming staff?
Well, what the nice thing about the artifact stuff is you're going to be able to customize it exactly how you want it to look. So if you're an arcane mage, but you're wearing all like cool fiery looking gear because you just think it looks awesome,
mm-hmm. transmogging.
You can have your staff be all flamey looking to match your outfit, and we're going to be able to that goes into getting those points from dungeon bosses and completing events out in the world and quest lines and stuff like that. But we're going to be able to adjust or create our artifact weapons in our class halls. That's where all of that's going to take place. We won't have to go back to a big city hub or anything like that. We just have to go back to wherever our hub or our class hub is, essentially, and do the stuff there.
Now, I know they mentioned the class hub or whatever. It's going to be kind of like their little garrison type deal.
You're not going to be by yourself in there. Into your class hall, you're going to see other Death Knights, or I'm going to see other Death Knights, you're going to see other mages, and we're going to, from the sounds of it, I'm going to be able to see other Death Knights who are Horde, and everybody will be friendly, quote unquote, to each other, so there won't be any fighting in your halls.
Which... I really like that. That's going to be really cool. You're not going to feel alone.
Nope.
And especially if you're with others of your class, you can talk to others about, you know, like, what does that? What does this? How are you playing your mage? How are you playing your Death Knight? You know, stuff like that.
And it's going to be great because in our little halls, we're going to be able to theorycraft and figure out the best thing we can do for our weapon that we're doing, because we essentially have a weapon tree that we get to build up in how we want to play it. The screenshot they showed from the Death Knight one, I've got a talent that I'm already planning to spec into that allows me to raise ally on myself or do it to one of my members in my party and raise them to full health, full mana.
Wow.
Yeah, tank goes down, I'm going to be able to pull that tank right back up to full everything. Or if a healer goes down, same thing. Or if we're pretty good, I can bring myself back to life because I'm just epic.
Yeah, because it'd be like giving, you know, battle res to them. I mean,
I do have a battle res. I do have raise ally.
Or not battle res. I meant resurrection. Oh, reincarnation.
Yes, a reincarnation. Yes.
Yes. Yeah. Which I think that's super cool. I mean, if everybody gets a new weapon that can do these other kinds of things, that's going to be great.
Yep. And just basing off the screenshot, this weapon tier, each of these little tier spots are going to have like ranks. So you might be able to like do rank 1 of 2 on this one, but 2 of 2 over here, and I don't know, maybe this one over here's got a 3 or something like that in it.
So bringing back the RPG element to the MMORPG.
That would be nice.
Giving players the ability to create their own character, to build their own character, instead of basically min-maxing, like, oh, this is the best spec, you can only play this way.
It's still gonna happen, yes.
A little bit.
But I feel there's gonna be benefits to just about everything.
Oh, yeah. Like, they're probably, what I'm thinking is they'll have, like, spells in there that you can only get to going a specific way, and each spell is beneficial in one way or another to a raid or a party, where it's like, hey, are you a mage with this? Awesome, great. You can, like, you're a shoo-in.
Come along.
Yeah, because we need that extra whatever that is.
Yep.
Or are you a Death Knight that can resurrect? Perfect.
Yup.
Like, especially if they're a tank Death Knight.
Oh my goodness.
Imagine that. Like, the tank goes down, it's like, don't worry, I got this. I'm back up. I got the aggro again. Everybody's still alive.
Oh, that's a brilliant thought.
Mm-hmm. So I don't
tank, but that's a brilliant thought, because that saves an essential res to maybe your high DPS number who goes down because of stupid RNG. Mm-hmm.
So, hi
World Tree, I miss you.
World Tree, what are you talking about? Where are you?
I'm over by the Twilight Grove. Excuse me, it's not a World Tree.
Oh, it's, yeah, one of the Emerald... Oh, you split up real far. I'm in Booty Bay.
Yeah, I know, I lost you. I kind of stopped in Westfall and reminisced.
No, it's cool. It's totally what this was all about, was just, you know, flying around and just talking about the expansion. I'm not really going anywhere in particular. I'm just going to really cool spots.
Speaking of which, I'm going to land in Duskwood over here at the Twilight Grove.
Okie doke.
Because...
welcome, meet ya.
Oh, hey, looky. There's a portal. And it's green.
Oh,
speaking of which, so portals in green made me think of Yashura. I don't know how to say that, the green aspect name. Starts
Yzara?
Yzara, thank you. They made mention about needing her help. Are our dragons coming back? ?
I really hope so. I hope dragons are making a comeback. Because...
the dragons...
They really brought order to the world of Warcraft. And I mean, without the, you know, the aspect of life, the aspect of magic, the aspect of time, I mean, who knows what the Burning Legion can really do?
Oh my goodness, I don't want to imagine it. They say we're going to wake up to a world of fire. I'm imagining all of our zones on fire. Do you remember,
like,
when
Deathwing flew over all the zones and started them on fire? Yes.
Everything was on fire, and I worked my butt off to get that stupid achievement.
Oh, God. Tell me about it, because, like, whenever, like, trade chat would just explode. They're like, Deathwing's here. And luckily, I was a mage, so it was like, they're like... Well, yeah, they were like, can I get a portal from here to here? I'll pay you. So it was like, people were just throwing me money to use my portals. It was great. I was getting money.
I had to fly my butt and hope to God I got there in time.
Yeah. Luckily, I was leveling an alt character and literally just ported to Aldim.
Mm-hmm.
I load in and... I died immediately. I load in, my character is dead. Everything's on fire, and I see an achievement. I'm like, what? how did this happen? I don't get it.
Hi.
I'm here. So, I think this might be where we end our video.
Okay.
Running into the portal.
Huzzah!
No, we touched base on a lot of really cool things. The new Demon Hunter class, the new zones, they all look gorgeous. Moose Tauren. We got some of the raids and instances, one of them being the Emerald Dream. That's awesome. I'm really excited about that.
Yeah.
I know other people have to be. Artifact weapons. Oh my god.
The PvP system, bring that back.
Everything. Just, wow.
This, wow. Wow is right.
Exactly. World of Warcraft.
I'm very hopeful for this expansion.
Me too.
It really sounds like they actually listened to what the vast normal populace of WoW has said.
Yeah, I think so too. I mean, Draenor was cool. I loved when we first went to Draenor. Everything was gorgeous. The garrison was fun for a while.
For a while.
But the fact that you had to do all of your professions and like you could go to your friends' garrisons and then do their professions, but the fact that you could only do your professions from your garrisons really made it
A single player game.
it made it a very highly single player game where you had to wait.
And wait.
Yeah, it was what, 4 hours to get a piece of cloth for tailoring or whatnot?
It was nuts. And finally, here at the end is when they put in rush orders, but by that point they were
Yeah,
useless
it
because you
was.
stockpiled.
You had everything. You
Yeah.
had so much stuff that, and the fact that it was all soulbound too,
Yeah,
that you
that
couldn't
was the
sell it.
butt part.
So I'm really wondering what they're gonna do with professions.
They didn't mention them at all, but
Exactly.
this was just the teaser stuff. This is just
True.
to get us our toes interested, get people thinking about coming back into WoW, what this could
Yeah.
mean. They said more information is going to be coming later this year. BlizzCon is in November.
Yes. Well,
So
and normally they release expansion packs and stuff like that at BlizzCon. The fact that they didn't, I mean, they're in a hurry. I think they really want to get this out because Draenor's going, I hate to say it, Draenor's going down.
down quick, like a sinking
It's,
ship.
yeah, they've lost a lot of subscribers, and I would love to really get back into the game like I used to play it. And if they're trying to get this out, I know
Don't
they
rush it, Blizzard. Please don't rush this.
don't rush it. Please, take the time to make this next expansion super awesome. I know that they want to do the beta later this year. I'm gonna try my best to get into that beta and see what I can do about checking it out. And
They did say that they've been working on this one for a while. What's a while, Blizzard?
I really hope when they announced Draenor, they were working on it.
That would be cool.
Because then if they were working on this expansion pack while Draenor was coming out, maybe that explains why
We
it went a
didn't
little
have.
more it went more demony in the end of Draenor instead of orcs.
That could be at.
Because I mean it went very, I'm like, I want to see some Iron Horde, I want to see some orcs, I want to,
But
orc stuff,
it
but
went total Burning Legion.
it went demon, and I lost interest. I'm like, so I mean, I wanted to smash some orc face in, like Garrosh. I mean,
We got to smash some orc face.
little bit, but I mean, like all of the orcs that they played up to make look super cool. It was like they were dungeon bosses,
Yeah.
or like the first boss in a raid, and you're
Yep.
like, what is that?
Well,
Aren't these guys supposed to be leaders of the Iron Horde?
Spoilers for anybody who out there who doesn't want a spoiler. There's some trailer stuff out there, or cinematics, cutscenes and stuff like that, with Gul'dan giving orcs the green potion goo stuff. I forget what it's called.
The demon blood?
The demon blood. And we see some transformation sequences on the orcs into like the fell orc look. So we
Yeah.
might see them a little in this next expansion. That was a thunder rumble, Batman.
I didn't pick it up.
Big enough that I heard it.
I don't know, maybe. But
We will have to wait and see. Right now,
either way,
it's wait and watch.
I mean, very first look at expansion stuff, and I mean, who knows what they're gonna throw in with like patches and stuff like that. I mean, this Broken Isles that we're going to is the home of Sargeras's tomb. So who knows? Are we gonna kill a Titan?
Possibly.
It's one of the only things we haven't killed in World of Warcraft yet. We've killed old gods. We've killed
dragons.
Dragons. We've killed elemental aspects. We have not killed a titan. I mean,
Titan. They did make reference to we're going to have to deal with them.
Mm-hmm. Well, and they had Algalon or Art, whatever his name was, in Aldum.
Yes.
But I don't think he was an actual titan, was he?
I
think he was a messenger.
I can't remember my lore right now.
Yeah, I think he was just a judge. He came down to check out the planet, and if it was the planet was bullshit, he would destroy it.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know if he was an actual titan, per se, and I'm saying titan with air quotes. But, I mean, Sargeras is basically the devil, and I say devil with air quotes. He is the devil of World of Warcraft.
Hey, they did say we're going to hell. We're riding with the Valkyr and going to hell.
Yeah, so I mean, who knows what we're going to see in this expansion. But I know
it sounds like they got a lot, and I'm hoping it lasts and we can ride it.
I know my interest is very peaked right now. Mm. And I want to know more. I want to see more. What's this Demon Hunter class like?
I want to play.
I know. But only time will tell. Who knows what they're going to announce at BlizzCon.
Oh, that's...
I mean...
That's soon.
It's very soon. November, it's... I mean, we might have to have another one of these fly-around theory-crafting sessions after BlizzCon.
Let's do it over on Kalimdor next time.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking, too. Over on Kalimdor. We'll go check out some cool stuff. But either way... I hope you enjoyed watching me fly around and talk about new expansion stuff with my friend Mal. And honestly, wow. Everything that came out from this press conference or Gamescom.
Gamescom.
Gamescom, thank you. Everything that came out from Gamescom about this next expansion blew my mind. Mm-hmm. I know I was at work at the time, and my mind literally just...
actually stopped working
for
a few minutes and watched the trailer. I'm certain my coworker looked at me and was like, what?
Yeah. I'm like hunched over in the cooler like, don't look at me.
Well, just I happened to be changing a podcast and the little announcement popped up and, you know, a minute, what was it? The trailer is like a minute 30, not even. And so it's not very long. But yeah.
Yeah. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed. I'm Shredly.
I'm Maleficent.
And we'll see you next time. Later!